In this video, we can take a look into adding service to a cluster using Cloudera Manager. So we have installed a cluster and initially I have selected HDFS and yarn component. So there are a lot of components that we call ecosystem components or services, so that we can add using Cloudera Manager. So go to the Cloudera Manager. So where I use the IP and the port 7180. And so go to the main page, home page, and you can see the cluster name. Just click here and use add service. So here I'm going to add a service called Zookeeper. So actually we will not use this service directly, but this is very important and important service which is used for service maintaining and other tasks. Actually, we will use this service along with other services. Zookeeper is a coordination service which use in our cluster. So continuing, and here we have option to select on what are the servers we need to install Zookeeper. So we can install Zookeeper on a single node or a multiple node. So if you are doing a multiple node, always use odd number. I mean to say three or more. Why? Because Zookeeper service. So if you execute, if you add Zookeeper as a cluster, I mean more than one Zookeeper service. So one leader and follower. So it uses a majority selection rule to find out. Okay. So say for example, if I have three servers and running Zookeeper service. So in these three, if two are up and running, so my entire Zookeeper service will be available. Suppose if majority fails, I mean, see if only one is up, then entire service will not be available. So in this case, I am adding a three. That means even if one fails, I will be able to continue the service. Suppose what would be the case if I use four? So why we are saying we need to use odd number three or more? See, if I use four, the majority is three, right? So this required the minimum three servers should be up and running. So that means we can handle the failure of one. So even in case of three also, we can handle the failure of one. So we use odd number. So 3, 5, 7, etc. So here I am using the three. Then continue. Okay. So I have selected the servers where I need to install. Continue this one. And this is the directory, the log directory where Zookeeper keep the log file, and the data log directory and data directory. Okay, /varlib Zookeeper. And here it's adding the services and initializing Zookeeper. It takes some time. So after adding, it has to start the service. So once it is started, then we can finish the installation. So while adding the service, it's always better to add the service Zookeeper first. Why? Because there are a lot of other services that depends on Zookeeper service. Okay. So here I am doing so post installation task because I just wanted to show you this process, how to add the Zookeeper. So always one thing you need to remember is, so you can see these are the leader. Okay, so leader and follower. So and also it uses a majority rules. So if majority of the services fails, the entire Zookeeper service will not be available. So you can see on the three servers it is running. And again, if you want to check the configuration, go to the configuration and you will have all the details. So if you want to change the any of the configuration, you can change, save and restart the service. So this is how we are adding Zookeeper service. So Zookeeper is very important because it is doing a lot of coordination activities. So before starting any other services, so make sure you added Zookeeper. So thanks for watching this video. So please subscribe to get more updates. Thank you. Bye.